Hello, hi, welcome to IT Online Trainings for You. Today we are going to discuss about one of the most popular security policy in our AnyPoint platform. Okay, so basically, why do we need to provide a security? Let's take an example. Everyone have a smartphones nowadays, right? So to use your smartphone, what you are going to do, you will set up a password. Right, without any password setting up, without any password or a pattern or a fingerprint or a face recognition, without setting up all these any one of the security pattern, what will happen? Anyone can use your phone, and anyone can erase the data, erase the photos, and anyone can misuse your phone and your data in your phone, right? So to avoid that, what you will do, you will set up a security. That is nothing but you will set up a password or a pattern or a fingerprint recognition, face print, face recognition. Likewise, for a smartphone, we are protecting everything, every possible way that is not going to be misused for some other person, right? So likewise, we are going to protect our API. See, this is our proxy API which we have created in our previous session. Right, what will happen without any security? If someone knows this URL, they can send and they can get that data. They can just use this data and they can receive the data. In our example, it is just a JSON, it's just a text. Text we are giving just for our demo purpose. But in real time, what will happen if someone is going to hit this employee database of an organization? What will happen? They will get all the employee data as a response here. It means like the employee name, mobile number, email ID, and every sensitive information they can access. Only thing they just need to know this URL. So anyone can use this proxy URL with proxy service, and they can access our actual employee data if we don't protect our API with this, any of the security policy. So that is why we are going to discuss today how to protect our proxy API. Okay, so let's see. I would like to set up some username password kind of security to my proxy. It means like if someone they are going to use my proxy, they need to provide that username and password to invoke this proxy URL. Okay, let's see how we can do that. To do that, just log into our AnyPoint platform. We have one specific policy for this, like say, client ID enforcement policy. Yeah, I just logged into my AnyPoint platform. Go to API Manager. Yeah, this is the API we have developed in our previous session, right? Just click on this version. If you can see this menu bar here you will find this policies section. Under this policies section, you will find all the pre-built policies provided by AnyPoint platform. See, here API level policies are there, automated policies are there. What is the difference between these two sections is like, if you can select any of the automated policies from this level, here you can find automated policies. This will be applicable to all the APIs and all the resources which are deployed in our Cloud Hub environment. Instead of that, specific to this API, I would like to apply one client ID enforcement policy. I don't want to apply this policy for all the APIs which are deployed in my environment. Okay, to do that, just click on this version. It will be open up your AnyPoint API window. You can just click on this apply new policy. And here, if you can observe, these are the many policies which are defined, which are provided by AnyPoint platform by default. You can protect your API these many as possible ways actually. So today we will see this client ID enforcement policy, and we will discuss all the other policies in our upcoming sessions one by one from scratch. Okay, so let's focus on this client ID enforcement policy for today. Just click on it. You need to select the latest version which is available. Okay, scroll down. You need to select that, and you need to click on configure policy. It will ask for some configuration steps. It means like where do we need to send this policy? I would like to send this client ID secret, which is nothing but the username and password. I would like to send these details into headers. While invoking my service, I need to pass this client ID client secret under header section here. Then I need to access my API. Without sending those values in the headers, I cannot get the response. Okay, let's go back. See, by default it will give you this attributes dot headers client ID, attributes headers client secret. These two are the main header values we need to provide while accessing the API. We can change this pattern, but for now we can just accept all the defaults. This is a client ID expression, client secret expression we should follow. Okay, and we have two different options here. Because in our API, we have, if you remember, we have three resources in our API. One is to get all the employee details, one is to get only particular employee details, and one resource is for to create one employee details into the database. So these two options, what will happen is, if you select this apply configurations to all APIs and method, it will by default apply this policy for all the resources. It means like whenever you want to invoke any of the employee get details or one particular employee details or to create employee, it will be, this policy will be applicable to all the resources. Instead of that, we can select only specific method if you want to apply. If you would like to select this apply configuration to specific methods and resources, it will ask you to select only particular resource to apply this policy. So for now, I will apply this policy for all the resources. Okay, just click on apply. Yeah, there you go. See, if you can see, this client ID enforcement policy is applied to my API, all API methods and all API resources. You can disable or enable this policy by using this actions tab here. So you can edit this policy, disable, and you can permanently remove this policy. These are the available options. Once you applied the policy, then you can actually manage these policies by using these actions. This is how we can apply the policy. After that, we need to do some changes in our RAML as well. Because we have applied this policy in our API, while consuming this RAML in any other application, we need to just provide those details in our Design Center RAML in order to apply that policy. Because we need to mention manually what are the headers to be passed to in order to invoke any of the resources, we need to send the client ID client secret as a headers, how we can configure in our RAML. So we can configure this client ID secret by using trait section. Under version, just go down. Here, this will suggest you these number of options actually. You need to select traits, and you can give any name for your policy. I am giving like client ID secret. Client ID secret policy. Okay. And here you can provide some description. And you can select what are the header variables you need to send actually. We are going to send this client ID secret as a headers, right? So you need to select the headers. And you need to provide this like this way you need to configure actually. What are the two header parameters? One is client ID, one is client secret, right? So let's do that. Client underscore ID. You can give any text here actually. You should give this required field as well, because these are the mandatory fields I would like to send from headers. I need to select required true. Otherwise, you can select required false. And type, what type of the value it is accepting? It is string actually. So likewise, we need to configure client secret as well. Client secret, you need to provide description. And type. This is also accepting string type actually. And then required parameter. So now we defined this client ID secret policy, but we need to apply this policy to our resources. So for now, what I can do is like, I can just apply this policy for my main employee resource. So to do that, just click enter under employee, and you need to apply this policy to our resources, you need to select ease types, and it will display our traits name here. This is the one we have actually defined here. If you can see, the client ID secret policy. So once you select this ease method, it will automatically pull up what are the policies we have defined earlier. So this is the one I have defined, and this is one I want to apply for this employee resource. Okay, you can just click on it. Also, you need to provide a responses section under this client ID policy. It means like if someone has given the wrong client ID, wrong client secret, you should send a response like it is unauthorized. I mean, wrong client ID, client secret they have passed. And we need to send one more response like this way. If someone is using a bad request or bad data or bad query parameters, if they have sent while invoking your service, you can send this response code, and you can say like bad response from authorized server. Okay, let's configure these responses. And here the syntax would while applying this policy, you should follow this syntax, like you need to give hyphen, then you need to select the policy, otherwise it will throw an error. Okay, so let's save it. By default it will actually getting saved. You need to publish this as a new asset version. Just click on publish. Publish to exchange. We need to give new version now this time, because the 1.0.0 is already published. So it will take a new asset version, 1.0.1. We need to update the same version to our proxy as well. Okay, just click on publish to exchange. It will take a couple of minutes to publish this. So once you have done any changes in your RAML, you need to redeploy the proxy actually. You need to select the latest version of the asset, and you need to redeploy your proxy. So to do that, I'm navigating to API Manager. If you can just click on this API version, it will show you the update is available for this RAML. So earlier it was 100, now we have updated it to 101, right? So you need to select this update drop down list. You can select view new asset in exchange or update asset. So I can directly update the asset actually. So current version is 100, it will show you the all the latest versions. You can select this. So in case if you need to roll back any changes in your RAML, you can just select the old version instead of rewriting the code. So I have updated the asset here. Now I need to redeploy my proxy. to do that, you can just go down and just click on this redeploy. It will take 2 to 3 minutes to redeploy. So let me pause my video here. So proxy is redeployed successfully. So let's close this window. Let's try to hit our service without sending any details. Let's try to hit our service. See, earlier you will get you got the response. Now if you can see, this is an error, authentication denied. It means like we have applied our policy successfully. So in, without sending those client ID, client secret values in header section, it will not allow you to access this resource. See, it will show you error response like 401 unauthorized. It means like it will control the end users or other persons that they do not access your API and resources and any data. So now how we can test this API, how we can test this proxy by sending the client ID, client secret in headers. To do that, we need to generate the client ID, client secret actually. To get that client ID, client secret for this API to test, you need to go to Exchange. Okay, you have already published this asset, right? You need to just click on it. And here you can see after the edit button, you can see three dots icon, right? If you can click on here, it will show you two options, request access and view code. You need to click on request access so that it will give you the actual client ID, client secret to access this API. Here you need to select the API instance. This is the API ID from the sandbox environment. If you have remember in the API manager, it will show you this API ID, right? You need to select that API. There is no active client applications, so you need to create one client application. You can give any name here. Demo test application. Okay, just click on create. And it will ask you for SLA tiers. For now, we didn't configure any SLA tier, so you can ignore this section. You need to just select this API instance and application name. Click on request access. So this is how the client ID, client secret, it will generate it for you. Okay. Just copy them into a notepad. Client ID, don't close that screen without copying those values. Okay, so let me go back. Now I'm just if you can click on this icon, it will automatically copy this value. Just click on it. So we have the client ID, client secret to access our API now. How can you send those values? Go to headers menu here. Under key, you need to give client ID, client underscore ID, client underscore secret. These are the key names. Let's test by sending a wrong client ID, client secret for now. I'm just giving some random values. I'm testing it. See, if you will get a response like invalid client. Unauthorized invalid client. So you need to send an actual client ID, client secret, which we have requested from the exchange. Let me copy those values. The first one is the client ID, right? You can just copy and give the value here. Second one is the client secret. So I have given the actual client ID, client secret, which is nothing but just like, for example, username and password to access this mobile application. Okay, just click on send. Now you will get the response. So without sending this client ID client secret, you will not get the actual response, and you will get a status code like 200 OK. It means like this is a success path and happy path of testing. Okay, so this is how you can apply client ID secret policy to any of your API to protect your service.